On this week's episode of Science and Star Wars,
may the Force be with you, Taylor Gray.
Lightsabers. Hello, and welcome to Science and Star Wars, where we explore how close real-world science has come to our favorite Star Wars technology. I'm Anthony Carboni, and joining me on the show is my friend here.
Hello, my name is Watson.
And today, we're talking about lightsabers. As Obi-Wan described them,
an elegant weapon for a more civilized age.
And by civilized, Obi-Wan meant mess some stuff up real bad. Watson, what can you tell us about lightsabers?
After reading every Star Wars film script and the StarWars.com databank, I have learned the lightsaber is a complex instrument consisting of a pommel cap, hand grip, control module, main hilt, focusing lens, and blade emitter, with an energy core powered by a kyber crystal.
Kyber crystals actually power both lightsabers and the Death Star. It's what makes them different from something like a blaster. The closest thing we have in the real world to a lightsaber right now is plasma. And in order to achieve that, you'll need a plasma arc welder. But still, lightsabers aren't real. We would also need... But that doesn't mean all hope is lost. No! In fact, at the National Ignition Facility in Livermore, California, there is a laser that can produce temperatures close to the center of the sun.
It provides about 100 times the power of the entire electrical grid of the world. And it all concentrates that in a tiny little spot for a billionth of a second, creating incredible temperatures and pressures, which enables us to study high energy density physics that we use to bring us future solutions to the energy problem of the world.
And at IBM Research Zurich, they're floating plasma in the air.
What's very intense with our laser is that we can focus this whole energy within 150 femtoseconds. So this is less than a millionth of a second. And this is what makes these beams then very bright and very intense. And then we can create a so-called quantum fluid. And with this quantum fluid, we can study these quantum mechanical applications for future computings.
Now, surprisingly, if you call the lab in Zurich and request to use their very expensive laser, but don't tell them why, they tell you no.
I wonder why.
Taylor, you are Ezra Bridger on Rebels. You have a lightsaber.
I've had two. Right now, I've got a green one.
Green is good. Watson, what color lightsaber would I have?
Based on my analysis of Star Wars materials and cross-referencing your social media handle for personality insights, your lightsaber color would be green.
Oh!
Look at that!
Twinsies! In the real world, lightsabers come in one color. Blinding, white, hot. What we're gonna do is make a Themic Lance. So we've got a carbon steel tube here. We have some steel wool.
Hey.
And a tank of oxygen. We're gonna run oxygen through this tube and then use the steel wool as an igniter.
There's iron flux in the steel wool, and when oxygen hits it, you get iron oxide. That is oxidation.
Yes! It creates a lot of energy in the form of heat, which means we are going to create a 2,000 degrees Celsius plasma blade. Okay, now this is a room to create plasma. We got Alan Pan with us. You're gonna be helping us build some of our experiments for the show. And you've made a Themic Lance lightsaber like this before.
Yeah, I did, but mine was smaller and hip-mounted. It looks like yours is gonna be a lot more powerful.
Dude, it feels legit. It looks legit. Let's see what it does.
All right, let's light this candle. I'm gonna ignite our steel wool. We're gonna start the oxygen flowing through that.
Woo! Let's do it.
So what we have is a 100-pound double pane steel fire door. Whoa. Yeah!
Yeah, we're through. Oh!
Woo! Oh, Taylor, it looks so rad.
I can feel the sparks.
Those are just your midichlorians, Taylor. Get us through that door, Taylor.
Look at this.
You can see the burning and the scarring and the oxidation. You can feel the heat coming off the stove.
That's full Qui-Gon.
Full Qui-Gon. That is awesome. Taylor Gray, I have to ask you, did we build a lightsaber today?
We built a very successful lightsaber. That was unbelievable.
Awesome, man. Thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.
And remember, we are just getting started. We have more here for you every single week and more science for you at ibm.com/Star Wars.
Look at that, dude, that's insane.